Hey guys, so it's a rainy day here in the ghetto, and I want to tell you guys about the tips and tricks that I wish that I knew when I started playing Drug Dealer Simulator. Now, the first one is that I wish I knew. The best way to start the game is by when you press your icon up here, you can see all of your drugs that you're selling. In the beginning of the game, you will have marijuana and amphetamine enabled. The first thing I wish that I knew is that the absolute best way to start the game is by disabling weed and just selling amphetamine. Alright, so the second thing that I wish I knew how to do was how to use this mixing board thing correctly. So what you do with it is that you go into equipment mode, you press F, and you never use it again. Now, what you should do though is that you wait until you have one of these. Like the mixing board, it's just such a mess. Like you get this one, like you can buy the proper mixer at like level 13 or something. You're not even moving big enough amounts at level like pre level 10 for it to be worth it using this thing. Just get rid of it. Just sell. Just buy and sell. Don't cut anything until you have this mixer or one of the other mixers that can mix with 100% accuracy, so you get exactly the same amount of product that you put in back out again. When it comes to milling items, then I wish that I knew that this mortar is the same kind of thing as the mixing board. If you use the coffee blender, for example, you won't get the same amount back out. It takes a little bit longer than the coffee blender, but using like have 10 of these instead of 5 coffee blenders, you get the same amount of product back out as you put back in. You get the same amount of product that you put in back out. Now, in the early game, you will have a lot of small orders. So another thing that I really wish that I knew about in the early game is that don't wait for like you get a 2 gram order or something like that, and then take out the exact amount that your clients want. Just have 10 2 grams, have 10 1 grams, have 5 3 grams. Let's say 6. Just have it in your bag. Don't take out what everyone exactly what everyone needs. Just have this in your bag as much as you can. 2, 3, and 1 grams are like they will cover absolutely everything that you need in the early game. If you get a 10 gram or 10 gram plus, then sure, take out 1 10 grammer. But don't spend time here all the time. Just have 1, 2, and 3 grams in your backpack all the time and save yourself a whole lot of time. Just look at the computer, run back out, look at the computer. And one thing that I really wish that I knew in the early game, and actually like I still use it even though I'm max level, is that you can run endlessly in this game. You can run without having stamina. The way you do this is that you run, you jump, you release the sprint button, and then press it right back again. When you land, you jump again. So let me just show you. So you can basically run forever, getting away from police and just saving time in general. Like in this short time, I've probably saved like 10-15 seconds. So what you do, you run, you jump, you release the jump button in the air, you press the jump button while still being in the air, and then you jump again as soon as you land. This way, you can keep running until the ends of the earth, or at least into this wall. All right, so this one is going to be slightly longer. I'm gonna hold on, let's turn off the game audio. So this one is gonna be slightly longer, but when I started playing the game, I really wish that I knew how to smuggle things over to sector B and back again properly. So let me show you how I like the method I found that I don't think anyone else, at least no one else, has posted it. So right here is when you where you deliver money to Eddie. Here is the junkyard, or I mean the hobo yard. What you do is you jump on top of these wooden pallets. You look at the wall here. This one is slightly lower, so you walk up to it. Like, if you see, you see that the wooden pallet has these openings, like one opening there and one opening there. One, two. So the white line at the end, at the bottom of my screen is going to be inside of the second opening. I look up, jump, throw my bags over, turn 90 degrees to the left, and enter this sewage hatch. Then I will come out. Okay, so finding this again is pretty easy. It's next to the cemetery. You have the blue car, trash bin, red car, sewage hatch. Run over to the red car and just run straight forward. Then you get to this little stair. So this is where I just jumped. Run right over to the corner, and here are my bags. On this side of the map, there's gonna be generally two places you deliver drugs to the cartel. So what you do is that you run over to this sign, to the grass, and next to the two silos right here, keep running. When you come to the end of this fence, you go over here. You have this red water container. And then there is this wall. So, silo, fence, around here to the left. That works, I guess. Throw your bag over. So this is the wall I just jumped over. You just walk straight forward around this wall. And here is the car that you generally deliver goods to. This is the other drop, where the cartel will ask you to drop your goods. So it's pretty safe. This one is harder, but with a little bit of care and tension, you will not get caught doing this with this route. Now, the way to get over to the other side is quite similar. For reference, here you have the sewage hatch that we just popped out of. Red car, and you just run straight forward, sort of, to this wall. I mean, the wall that you want to get back over. Then, right next to the checkpoint, you will find this rail. Once again, we have one block of the wall that is a little bit lower. Get close, jump throw, and go back to the hatch again. Now, obviously, I'm doing this during daytime, so I don't need to worry about the police so much. For the sake of this tutorial, I don't need to show you guys how to be careful. But anyways, here is the yeah, whatever. Red car, and here are your bags. Now, that was the glitchless way to do it. The glitched way to do it is you stand in front of the gas station right here. Go over to this corner, you see these two trash cans, and then you have the gap in the wall. I don't know who found this, but I'll leave a shout out to the guy that I learned it from in the description. So you throw that. Hold on, let me do this again. So you throw this, your two bags next to the crack, you turn 90 degrees, run over to the road. When you're at the road, you turn 90 degrees to the right, walk a few steps forward, and then you look down, and there's the sewage hatch. From here, from the sewage hatch, you run through this gap, to the left a little bit, and here is your bags. Now, another thing that I really wished that I knew when I started playing this game is that if you get the police running after you, you can simply just run into your apartment and they won't find you. Hold on. Let me just... Yeah. Point is, as long as you're inside here, the police will not find you. They'll simply just keep running. A really good method to buy a lot of drugs at the same time, especially when you're selling to the cartel. The cartel will give you these briefcases with way more cash than you can possibly put into them physically yourself. So a really good way to buy a lot of drugs at the same time is that you simply order from Eddie. Maximum order. Deliver cash for cartel. You ask him to meet you for a payment right away. Run over to him and pay. Now I'm back at the computer and I can do the same thing again. Make new order, cocaine, maximum amount, pay for it. Ask for him to meet you so you can pay him money. Rinse and repeat, and all of the drugs that you buy right now is just gonna be on the next delivery they give you. So that's a really helpful thing if you wanna just buy a whole lot of drugs and keep cooking it, start mixing out. All right. So last but not least, the ability to run indefinitely is pretty useful. The way you do it is basically you need to sprint, jump, release the sprint button, push the sprint button, and as soon as you land, you jump again, release the sprint button, push the sprint button, jump in the air. You gotta press and release the sprint button because once you run out of stamina, then the sprint thing will automatically disable. So you just release and push sprint button to enable it again. The reason why this works is because while you're in the air, you're going to regain a little bit of stamina. And to jump, you don't really need any stamina. It takes 5% stamina to jump, but you can still jump if you have 0.01% stamina left. So as of this patch right here, I think it's 0.6. This works, and it's the most valuable tip in this game, quite literally. There is no greater time saver, and there is no better way of escaping the police, which I'm gonna demonstrate right here. So this is the last thing I'll do in this video. So if somebody learned something, please hit like and subscribe. Good luck in the game. Have a really good day, and I'll play us out here.